Good morning! It is Tuesday, October 27th. I'm late for work. It does get later than this, but still. I'm late for work. Slightly annoyed. Took a muscle relaxer last night for my back and stuff like that. And those things just don't want you to wake up in the morning, so they force you to sleep 2 hours past your alarm. Now, we're going to have a little discussion here, and I'm going to warn you guys now. Some of you may walk away from watching this blog and think I'm a bitch, or think maybe that I'm materialistic, or I'm assuming that everybody has all the money in the world to do whatever, but it's not the case of that, because on no scale am I Paris Hilton. Yes, I make an effort to afford the things that I want. So if I want something nice, I make an effort to afford it, okay? And this is where this whole conversation begins. Let's talk about you females going to all these parties and posing up in these pictures and doing all kind of something thinking you're cute. Now, we have a problem here. I'm going to call this an epidemic. We have an epidemic in our city that has to do with black females. Now, I'm going to specifically focus on black females because, number one, I am black. I'm not saying that these issues don't happen in any other race, but I'm speaking about the black females because, in a sense, they represent me. It's like that whole stereotype about black girls are bitches. Once y'all started cooking up that attitude and giving it out freely, everybody assumed all black girls were bitches, okay? So you're making people like me look bad. So we're gonna talk about the aesthetic bitches, okay? And when I say aesthetic bitches, I mean the girls that are making us look bad aesthetically. Ladies. For example, go through Foresight video or something like that. They have a group online. You can find it on my page because I'm in the group. And basically, they're one of the photographers, many photographers in the city, that attend parties or are hired at parties to do the photography there. I go through those pictures when they're posted, when I'm bored, just to see, you know, what people are wearing, etc., what happened, whatever the case may be. Disgusting trend, lace fronts, ladies, lace fronts. If you're buying a synthetic lace front, you're wasting your money, you're wasting your time, and you look ridiculous. Why? They look ridiculous. Some of you are able to find a mediocre lace front, a synthetic one, and you, those of you who can pull it off, that's because you know how to put it on and you're doing whatever, and it looks okay. The majority of you females, number one, probably went and bought a Beverly Johnson lace front, okay? I know you did it. I know you went to fucking Classics up at Victoria Park and Shepherd, and I know you went and bought a Beverly Johnson piece of shit, which just comes in a little package, and there is mediocre, not really good instructions as to how to put it on, which is why you guys look terrible. Terrible. I'm sorry, but lace fronts, synthetic hair, I don't even think really people should be wearing synthetic hair anymore. I don't know. Maybe it's because I don't, and maybe it's because I won't anymore, but I don't know. I just think that people need to invest in yourself. If you want to play like you're cute, you want to be hot, whatever the case may be, you want to talk about lace front this, lace front that, buy a real one. Don't cheat yourself and buy a synthetic one and then get somebody who knows what they're doing to cut the lace for you and show you how to properly put it on so you don't walk around looking like a friggin' retard and go posing up in pictures like you're friggin' hot. Another thing we need to talk about, investing in yourself, in your pride. These outfits some of you guys are wearing, I personally, depending on the event and the occasion, yes, I want a custom-made outfit that I know no other woman is going to have in the place, because who wants to be up in a gym wearing the same thing as somebody else? Then you got to worry about who looks better. If that happened to me, I wouldn't really need to, because of course, nobody looks better in my eyes, right? Why would I say somebody looks better than me? They don't. Everybody knows this. Anyways, so yes, if you guys want those custom-made outfits, you want to make sure no other female is going to have it and you want to turn heads and catch people's eye, that is perfect. That is what you should be doing. What you should not be doing, number one, is sewing your own goddamn outfit, okay? I seen this girl in this white something or other. I think it was like supposed to be some type of kimono style dress, but it just looked a hot mess. I don't know who sewed it together or tacked it together. You can't even really call it sewing, but it was horrible, absolutely terrible. Y'all need to go someplace and get it done properly, and it doesn't mean it's expensive. You guys can see in my pictures, Bashment Time, I have on a white one-piece cat suit, and it's halter and really low cut back. I got that custom made for Pimper's Paradise 2008, and it cost me less than $100, and it fit like a dream because the girl knows what she knows what she's doing. If anybody wants to see her, she is at Seductions, custom swimwear and lingerie at in Oshawa on Simcoe. So that's big up her for that. Lace fronts, just so I can give a little plug. Lace fronts on Facebook, Pink Diamond. She has a salon called The Salon out in Etobicoke. Big her up. She gets some quality ass anything. If you're not into lace fronts and you need weave or whatever the case may be, cut and style, go to Pink Diamond. Go to Pink Diamond. She's on my page. I'm telling you. So you guys need to invest in the craft and stop getting these makeshift outfits. Makeshift outfit, makeshift lace front, fucked up makeup, you guys are a mess. It's a mess. And too many of you are out there doing it. Too many of you. And even when you don't make your own outfits, I know everybody wants to be colorful and bright and have their own style and make things different, but can we make an effort to look proper? You guys have to think about what materials you're wearing with other materials. You can't rock satin and fleece, okay? It doesn't work out. That's ugly. It's horrible. So there's that. Another epidemic you guys are suffering with. Suffering. It's eyebrows. Not to mention, you guys don't blend your makeup properly to begin with. And when you go behind a camera and the flash goes off, it picks up all of that, okay? But on top of you guys not knowing how to properly do your makeup, you guys have the nerve, the audacity, the balls, the gall, I wouldn't even say the sense, because clearly you have no sense. But anyways, you guys remove your eyebrows, like the hair, and then you draw them on. Why? Why? I don't even know how to, like, I don't know what to say to you guys with that. That's just, it's like, you guys look terrible. Don't go get a Sharpie marker, which is what it looks like, and start drawing on freehand eyebrows. You don't know what you're doing. You don't have a lick shit clue what you're doing, because you look terrible, and you always do. I'm sorry, I do not like drawn on eyebrows on anybody. I don't care how nice you do it or think you're doing it. It's terrible. Everybody knows you don't grow ink from your skin, okay? It looks horrible. If you would like to have your eyebrow and you'd like to add a little bit of shape or tint it, or even just give yourself a tail if that's what you're missing, whatever the case may be, sure. But make sure, number one, you're buying the right pencil. Don't go buy jet black ink and start drawing on. No, get a soft black eyebrow pencil, not eyeliner. There's a reason why there's a difference, okay? There is a reason. And figure out how to do it properly. If you need to buy stencils, buy a stencil, because I'm sorry, y'all shouldn't be freehanding. You guys aren't no friggin' Michelangelo, okay? You guys are just regular girls attempting to uplift yourself physically, aesthetically, whatever. And that's good. This is what you should be doing. But do it right. If you're gonna do it right. Invest in the craft. And if you're really hell-bent on drawing on your eyebrows, etc., how about you go to a salon and get them tattooed on? Get a professional to pick the right shape of eyebrow for your face and your eyes and get it tattooed on properly. That way, you don't have to worry about going to the club dancing and your eyebrows sweating down your cheek or something like that. That's the next thing. You guys look terrible, and I'm really sorry that I...